And they take it? Or will it go to the Tennessee Titans? Because I am absolutely loving them. I am loving them. They really just, every worry that I had about the Titans went out the window last night. The way they won, the way they came back, the way they fought on a short week. Oh boy, I am loving this. The one knock on the Titans coming into this game was, I don't know if they can go out and put up that 42 points when they need to. Remember last year, they would face the Chiefs in the AFC Championship game. We didn't think Ryan Tannehill could keep up with them offensively, and we were right. They allow Ryan Tannehill to throw the ball a ton of times, and he just was not able to keep up. Then came the Titans last week. They put up 40 huge points, but then we dove deep into the stats a little bit, and it kind of worried us a little bit. Ryan Tannehill didn't throw for 200 yards, and Derrick Henry didn't rush for over 100 yards, but somehow they put up 42 points. So my main concern moving forward from last week of the Titans was, yeah, they put up the points, but they really kind of didn't. If you looked, it really, their defense helped them, got them short fields, got some nice turnovers, but it wasn't this Tennessee offense carrying them, and that was my one main concern. But they put all of that to bed last night. They get to host this Houston team that is playing fearless, you know, the substitute teacher of the Texans. They were looking good. They put up their most points with Romeo Cornell as the interim head coach of the Texans, and they go and put up 30 points, and then yesterday they put up 36, and I'm thinking, oh boy, how are the Titans going to deal with this? But they dealt with it exactly how the Titans deal with things down there in Tennessee, and we've got to appreciate these stats. Ryan Tannehill throwing the ball 41 times, 4 touchdowns, 1 pick. Absolutely magnificent. Tannehill, what a performance. 30 of 41. Absolutely magnificent. And then Derrick Henry, what did he do? 22 carries for 212 yards, 2 touchdowns, 9.5 yards a carry. That's why you pay the man. That's why that man wears the crown. King Henry, just everything was working offensively for the Texans. The passing game was there for 364 yards. The running game was there for 212 yards. The touchdowns were there. 6 touchdowns total. I mean, this was a complete game from the Texans, or from the Titans, excuse me. Oh, and plus they also got down. Oh, and plus they also had a fourth quarter comeback win. I mean, we've got to check out the drive summary. Here we go. We've got the Titans coming out to a big lead, 14-0. But then the Texans, you know, they're like, hang on, we don't got a head coach, y'all. It's Romeo Cornell. Oh, yeah, we playing free. We playing loose. And then they start to catch a little bit momentum coming in late of the first quarter. They finally get their first touchdown, looking good. Nice little drive here, 13 play, 82 yards. But then the Titans really kind of canceled it out with 11 plays, 85 yards, 5-minute drive of their own. And then the Texans kind of settle for a field goal going into halftime. And the Texans try to pick it up, a nice little touchdown there. And then the Titans fumble, and we really don't see that too often from this Titans team, so freaked us out a little bit. And now they officially had the lead, scoring a touchdown off of the turnover. You love to see teams, you know, cashing in on those turnovers. Love to see it. So they're officially up, but then Ryan Tannehill shuts it up a little bit, but then Deshaun Watson comes back with a play of his own. We got to talk about this Derrick Henry 94-yard rush. This is why you pay the man. This is why this Titans team works so well, because if it's not the ground game, it's going to be the passing game, and when it's not the passing game, it's going to be the rushing game like it was here. They're down two, and Derrick Henry, he's not only fast, he's not only strong, he's not only tall, the man is quick. The man is quick. You don't go 94 yards only being touched once if you don't have great speed. Look at that man run. Oh my goodness, what a rush, folks. Best rush of the season, and it's you know, probably one of the most underrated rushers in the league, Derrick Henry. He needs all the credit he deserves. He's only getting better every single year, and he's having a fantastic season so far. So with that Derrick Henry run, they go up and reclaim the lead. But then Deshaun Watson says, anything you can do on your legs, I can do better with my arm. And here it is. We're going to get a nice 53-yard touchdown pass from Deshaun Watson. Look at all the time to throw. Just absolutely loads up. And that's the strengths of this Houston Texans team. Their receivers, they have four, like, starting receivers on the team. Brandon Cooks, Randall Cobb. I mean, they're all out here, folks. So Deshaun Watson throws the touchdown pass, and then we have an interception by Ryan Tannehill, and now the Texans go and score another touchdown, but they don't get the two-point conversion. So once again, another two-point conversion not going this week. That's the third one we've talked about so far today. But then it's all on the line. It's Ryan Tannehill, Derrick Henry, a minute 45 seconds left, down 7. What do they do? Well, they do big play after big play after big play after big play. They get it down to 2nd and 1 on Houston's 7-yard line, and they go, and it's a, what do we got here? A no huddle Ryan Tannehill pass 7 yards to A. Brown. What a performance there to tie it up. And then we get overtime, baby. And what do we got? They win the toss, and it's going to be a 53-yard pass to Derrick Henry to set up their long gain here. Look at him go. Just throw it to him. The speed is there. The speed is there, folks. Oh, my goodness. We have to rewind this. Look at all the space he has here. And look at the defender just not able to run him down. So Derrick Henry goes all the way to the 25-yard line. Go to the down to the 25-yard line. And then we're just going to go methodical from there. 17-yard run, 2-yard run, 3-yard pass. Bingo, bango, Titans in overtime. Very close game. Came down to Titans winning the coin toss and just taking the first score and goes down the field. So absolutely loved what I saw from the Titans. I'm going to tell y'all right now, yesterday I was having them. I already put them as my number one. I'll see if I calm down by tomorrow, but I think we're going to have a new number one in the rankings. Unfortunate, Seattle's on a bye this week, so they can't really kind of try to match what the Titans did. But man, oh man, what I saw from the Titans to put up 42 points again on a short week and just doing it by the playmakers. Ryan Tannehill making plays, Derrick Henry making absolutely huge plays. The playmakers arrived. That was kind of my one concern. Could they do it when they needed to? And they did it when they needed to. They were down against a high-powered Houston offense, and they were able to put up 42, game-winning drive in overtime. They showed me everything. All right, let's talk about this Houston team because they had a good performance as well. Deshaun Watson, 28 of 37, 335 yards, 4 touchdowns, no pick. Absolutely fantastic. David Johnson had a decent game as well, 19 carries for 57 yards, 1 touchdown, pretty good. Now let's look at these receivers of the Texans. Will Fuller, 6 receptions for 123 yards and a touchdown. Darren Fells, 6 receptions for 85 yards. Brandon Cooks, 9 receptions for 68 yards. Farrell Brown with 2 receptions, 28 yards. And Randall Cobb, 3 receptions for 17 yards. So once again, just going to their main weapons here, Will Fuller, Darren Fells, Brandon Cooks. I mean, these are all very great receivers. And Houston doing it the right way, going to their receivers for all these yards. Their top 5 receivers or top receptions, top receiving yards are all wide receivers and not tight ends and not running backs like some of the other teams we've been talking about today do it. The Texans do it all by their passer, Deshaun Watson, and their fantastic group core of wide receivers. So I loved what I saw from Tennessee. And Houston, I mean, this is a great performance as well. Don't get me wrong. I mean, we learned a lot from Houston. They're still putting up 36 points. That's the most they've scored this season. So they're still feeling good without their head coach. And we could still look for them to be great value if we're betting them. So still like what I'm seeing from Houston as well. All right, 4.